Namaste. If you want to edit a book in Adobe InDesign, you want to open an ENDD file. Let me find the latest version of the Hushine. Okay, there's an flower. Let me find the Hushine. There she comes. Okay. It is similar to Word, but so when I want to see pages, I have to scroll. See, so I have to scroll. Okay. So if I want, if I click. The frame is chosen. If I want to edit text, I press this button and I can actually edit or copy part the text. So if I look at the page, so the numbering is it's here. You can see the pages, and here are the layout templates. You see that these are numbers which are inserted. Okay. So, for example, let me search for a mistake, something I want to fix. So I can use keyboard shortcuts with Control Plus. I can zoom in, Control Minus zoom out. If I want to change the style, styles are here. This is, I guess I'll have to rename them in English. This will make it italic. This will make it, and see, we can change everything, or without style. I guess I should make it this way. Scroll down, scroll left. You can search for text, Control Copy, Control F. You can search. So be careful for searching only in the place where I selected. I need to search in the whole document. And I can replace as well with something. I can replace even style, one style with another style. Okay. Okay, so I have found a mistake. Nothing can come after danda in this text. So if I will press enter, you would see a huge break. We don't want such a big one. So I press backspace and I hold the shift button and press enter, and that would make a small one. That is what I want. I don't want to make it big. So you see there are still issues to be found. And I guess this was not the last one. So, for example, you see that this line, this line after text, when we have enough place, is actually a style. You can see it. This is called separator. So these are paragraph styles. These are symbol styles. So when you style a paragraph, this means this whole text has a paragraph style, but in this paragraph style some parts have, let's say, symbol or separate word style. So if I'll change the paragraph style, the whole text will change. So for example, we can edit this. So we can edit the spacing before, after. We can change the name. We can change the color. It's here. Font size. Font spacing. Name. What I can do is actually I can search for the root sign. It doesn't matter that it doesn't show up in the font because it's a non-Unicode sign in this font I use. But we can easily find all those root signs. This is something that should not be breaking. It's an Russian abbreviation, so we just press shift and enter, and now it will be as it should be. Actually, I should search for all of them. Just to make sure that they don't break, because Natalia was very upset when she saw that there are some broken abbreviations. I don't know if that will actually find something broken, or it will look only for the ones which are non-broken. So I don't know. So the fact is that not all grammar terms have a style. I guess it's wrong. The fact is that those ablative singular ones have nothing, and I guess italics would be the best one to give them. So you see it has a style, header one style, savitri style, this is bibliosaur style, you can see this is subhashita style. It's different from the Santipur Sanskrit style, which is the default one. Sometimes if a word doesn't fit a line, let me find you an example. This is too long, it will never fit here, but if it is really short, we can do a trick and let them find a place where we can test it actually. Oh, you see one more. One more is there. And here I have removed the spacing before Danda, so the Danda would fit. So I can actually do the trick here. So it's 100%, and I could do try 99 or 98. Okay, you see, so it fits now. It's not as wide as before, but anyway, it fits and it looks better. Okay, you see this after the simha. I would want to have a shift enter, not just enter. So let me try. I don't go below 19. Okay, so it's good. 92. Yeah, maybe even 93. Oh, why not? I guess it is better than just having one more line. It's not as aesthetically pleasing, but so this is a new trick. I did not use it before, but now I do. And as these are different styles, you cannot have shift enter. You can have only enter between them, between different styles. This is your non-Unicode Gudakesha font. I love the French style, so that's why I have it. Lot of pain because of it. Still, okay, let me see. I can do with the Avogadro's. They are okay. Let me do it like this. So we will make the book more Indian. Okay, so enough for now, and there's one more text I want to check. And we save, or save as. Now we save. How do we make a PDF export? Export a print version of Adobe PDF. If we have the file with the same name, we overwrite it. I have some selection, but it doesn't matter. What matters, I export pages. All pages. I add this metadata, but it's not important. Okay, so press the button. If any error message arrive, okay. Now I wait. I'll wait about 3 minutes. Text exported. It it will not show me if it has exported. I have to find it myself. So it's in the process of exporting. It's now zero, so there is no such PDF file now. So that way you don't have to comment in the PDF. You can edit right in the Adobe file, and after you edit, you just hand over the Adobe file. Every day I make corrections, I make a new file name, so I have a few of them already here. Okay, now you see it's ready. So it's a beauty. Hope that helps, and you can implement proofreading